Right, today I'm going to talk to you about the anatomy of the Bailey bench plane. I shall be using my number 4 and my number 5 Bailey bench planes, both of these by Stanley. The only difference between these two planes is the length of the sole. The number 4 being shorter is more useful for smoothing. The number 5 being all the length of a component in a piece of furniture is more useful for preparing components. But both planes can be used for either of those jobs if enough care is taken. The main parts of the plane are the body, the rear handle or tote, and the front handle or knob. And then the blade assembly, which sits upon a frog. The bottom of the main body is referred to as the sole. The rear of it being the heel, the front of it being the toe. And there is a slit through which the blade emerges to take shavings. That's called the mouth. The blade assembly can be removed from the plane by releasing the lever at the top of the lever cap or cap iron, which comes out like so, and then the chip breaker attached to the blade. The lever cap is a fairly stout casting with a piece of spring steel and a lever, and a hole through which the screw in the frog is engaged. Pushing the lever down tightens the lever cap onto the iron, preventing it from moving from the frog. The blade and chip breaker can be separated by undoing the screw which screws into the chip breaker. And careful to slide the edge of the blade well away from the chip breaker, twist it round, and then lift off. This is a replacement blade in this Stanley. This is manufactured by Hock. The chip breaker is a Hock chip breaker as well. They're a matched pair and they make a nice improvement over the original Stanley. The hole you see in the chip breaker is where the screw in the frog comes through. The slot in the chip breaker is what attaches the blade assembly to the advancement mechanism in the frog. It's now a lot clearer to see the frog, which is basically a sloped ramp down which the blade is either advanced or retracted to get the shaving of the thickness that we require. We can remove the frog by releasing the two machine screws which have been revealed having removed the blade. And it just lifts out like so. The frog has a flat ramp which is machined at the factory and which you can probably improve upon yourself. It also has an advancement tang that comes through here and engages in the slot in the chip breaker. That passes through the frog and is coupled to this knurled knob for advancing and retracting the blade. There's also a lever which is riveted to the frog, which has a circular washer on there that sits in the slot in the blade, and that's for the lateral adjustment. The screw in the top of the frog is where the lever cap iron engages to hold the whole assembly together. And there's this U-shaped plate screwed to the back of the frog, which engages in an adjustment screw in the body of the plane to move the frog backwards and forwards in the body of the plane. The frog is seated on this E-shaped pad and these two straight pads. Again, they're machined in the factory and you can probably improve upon the mating of those surfaces. The frog sits in the body of the plane on two pads down by the mouth and two pads further back. Again, they're machined in the factory and once again the mating of those to the frog can almost certainly be improved by the user. There's a screw mechanism in the back here for advancing and retarding the frog in the body of the plane. The effect of that is to achieve a setting between the front of the iron, front of the blade, and the very front of the mouth. So we can close up that gap, which will give more support to the fibres we're planing, but it also will reduce the thickness of the shaving that we can take. The front handle or knob can be removed by undoing the screw through the top. These sometimes crack and it's nice to be able to replace them. The rear handle is attached by a screw at the base and a screw through the length of the handle. I often find the rear handles or totes to be loose on the body of the plane, and even tightening up these screws makes no difference. If we remove the handle, we can see that this mating surface needs to mate well with that in the plane body, and if we can achieve that, we should be able to tighten down on the screws such that it won't move around. Another option is to fix a piece of wood on the bottom of the handle that sits into this little gap in the body of the plane. Effectively making a tenon. That's all there is to a Bailey plane. And now if I reassemble it, I can show you some of the adjustments we can make. I'm attaching the frog, but not fully tightening these two machine screws that hold it down. Now, by turning this machine screw at the back of the frog assembly, I can move the frog forwards or backwards in the body of the plane. I've popped the blade back in, and now we can see the gap between the front of the blade and the sole at the front of the mouth. And you should see, as I turn the frog adjustment screw, that we can open that gap up, or we can close it down. If we wanted to take reasonably thick shavings, then we want the mouth opened up. If we're trying to support highly figured wood and to reduce tear out, then we'll want to reduce the thickness of shaving we're taking and reduce the gap between the front of the blade and the front of the mouth. Once we've achieved the gap that we want for the work we're going to do, we remove the lever cap and the blade. The there is usually a certain amount of movement left in the frog after we've adjusted and before we've tightened up these machine screws, and that will throw out the lateral adjustment on the blade. So the best thing I can suggest you do here is to try and square it up as much as you can to the body, tighten up those screws, pop the blade back in, and check the lateral adjustment on the blade. What we're aiming for is the blade to be parallel in the mouth when the lateral adjustment lever is sitting over the middle of the rear handle. That will allow us good adjustment either way. Tighten up the machine screws holding the frog down. Don't over tighten them, because it is a casting and we can deform the shape of either the main body or the frog by over tightening, and we can in fact crack the castings. Turning to the chip breaker and blade, by loosening up on the screw we can slide the chip breaker forwards and backwards in relation to the blade itself. The chip breaker is there to provide support and rigidity to the cutting edge, and the maximum support and rigidity we can get is when the chip breaker is very close to the edge of the blade. But this will also make it difficult to take thick shavings. So if we wish to take thick shavings, we pull the chip breaker back from the edge of the blade, or if we're doing smoothing work, or we're working on some highly figured material and we're going for very thin shavings, then we advance the chip breaker up close to the edge of the blade and tighten them together. Now we can put the chip breaker and iron back into the plane, just being careful not to touch the edge of the blade against anything where we might chip it. Make sure that the lateral adjuster is engaged in the slot in the blade and that the depth of cut adjuster is located in the slot of the chip breaker. Then replace the lever cap and close the lever down. It should close quite easily. The tension on the lever cap should be set using this screw into the frog to the point where we can still make lateral adjustments to the blade, and we can still advance and retract the iron. If you find those adjustments are too difficult, too hard to make, slacken off this screw slightly. If the whole assembly moves when you use the plane, then you'll need to tighten that a bit. You should find your plane is now ready to use.